I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one. You don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why, but we gonna win anyway. I came straight out the with a microphone. Boy, I swear I couldn't leave that mic alone. Everybody clear the room, I like to write alone. I'm in my zone, bass bouncing off the styrofoam. I'm never in between, I'm either hot or cold. Can't be a loser, I maneuver like I got a clone. I'm out here in these streets like I ain't got a home. And you barely hear from me like I ain't got a phone. Because there's no days off, there's no days.
Time to finally raise a Super Bowl banner in Philadelphia. I'm the coach, and this is the return of the NFL on EA Sports. Tonight, we kick off the new season with the return of Carson Wentz, ready to go in week one as the Super Bowl champion Eagle take on the new $100 million man, Matt Ryan, and the Atlanta Falcons. I'll be back at halftime with a look ahead to the weekend. But for now, let's get to Philly and say hello for the first time to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Just a short time ago, these Philly fans in full roar as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. Pyrotechnics ablaze. They're set to go as their Eagles will match up with the Atlanta Falcons. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Eagles team as they interplay here. Scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Here's Wentz to throw.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
Now Wentz on third down. Flush to his right. They find some open field here. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Give him 8 on the play. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here.
And hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
Now it's Ajayi, and this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats, but really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step.
And Jeffrey's got it! And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. They go play action here on first down. Jeffrey with a catch left side. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Give him 30 yards there.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays,
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, thrown back across his body. Ricardo Allen with a pick, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field.
And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. And out now come the Eagles. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Play action. Now Wentz. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Grady Jarrett able to swap him from that defensive tackle spot for a loss of five. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. To throw, it's Wentz. And that's incomplete.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions, that confident veneer that you have. It's chipped away a little bit. Maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, under throwing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind.
There we go. Back.
On third and long, it's Wentz. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up. Start out on the ground with a giant. So he got three and one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Two minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. A reminder coming up at halftime, it's the season debut of the coach, Jonathan Coachman, in Orlando as we look ahead to all the action coming up this opening weekend. And of course, we'll also take a look back at this first half. And not much there at all as he'll get this only up to about the 11. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and four now.
I think if they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick, and he'll return it to the 24-yard line. Set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. The first throw for the backup, Foles. And he's got the veteran here. It's Mike Wallace. And he's brought down, but not before getting across midfield to the 45.
A good pickup there, a 22. Here's Foles. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Now a hit, and Foles loses the football. It's out, and the Falcons grab it, and they'll take over inside the... Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. The Eagles on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and eight. Now Foles, and he will not be able to get away as Foles is taken down. So we have reached halftime here in the Thursday night opener. All right, we will see. And he'll get this up to about the 40. Tackle made there by Robert Alford.
He's had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Foles caught by the tight end Ertz. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A play fake as they set up to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
I think we've seen this before.
Here we go.
Someone's down three scores. That situation there is just going to add to their growing frustrations, don't you think?
Yeah, a bad number three right now. Three-score game, third quarter, three and out, not what they wanted. And you can tell on the sideline, those faces are getting a little bit longer as this one goes. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Vic B. He'll look to throw. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A good pickup there, a 22.
As far as tight ends go, this guy's not a speed burner. He's much more of an inline blocking type of a tight end. But how about this last play? Made a nice catch and picked up a first down.
That's what impresses me about him. When he's called upon, usually gets it done. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Ertz over the middle. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. That catch good for 5. It's third down. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on him.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner. And I don't think with 3 scores.
Start the drive. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time? Hopefully with a chance to win.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
He'll drop to throw. Goes underneath for Sproles. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Here we go. Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. The Eagles offense back out onto the field. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today.
Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And that is going to be pulled in one-handed. Wow. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. They'll look to throw. And this one incomplete. So the clock stopped now with 20 seconds remaining.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Trying for the tight end, Ertz, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford, and his guys will take over. Well, my friend, for the players, it's good for them to get that first game under their belts. For you and I, that first Thursday night game, also good for us to get that under our